Hello, and welcome to this demo on getting started with the Calico Kubernetes networking tool. So to start out, I'm in Google Cloud, and I'm going to go ahead and create a new Kubernetes cluster for this demo. Let's go ahead and go to the Kubernetes engine page. And you see, I don't have anything right now, so I'm going to go ahead and open my Cloud Shell. And Cloud Shell is primarily where I'll be working for this demo. Let's go ahead and create our Kubernetes cluster. I've got the command saved off here. We're going to create a new cluster called Calico Demo Cluster, and we're going to enable the network policy add-on. We'll also make this in US Central 1A, and we'll limit it to just 2 nodes. I'll go ahead and pause the video here and let this create, and I'll resume once it's done. All right, we're back here in GKE, and our Kubernetes cluster is up and running. Now, the next thing I have to do is download the Calico CTL binary from GitHub, and I'm just going to grab the latest release there. Next, I'm going to go ahead and make it executable, and then I will create a sim link to that in my user local bin directory so I have access to it on the system path. So now that that's set up, you can see I've got my Calico CTL version here. It's worth noting you don't have to do this on Cloud Shell. You can do this on any control machine that you're managing your Kubernetes cluster from, or even install it as a separate pod inside your Kubernetes cluster. It's a pretty versatile installation process. But now that it's on the system path, I can use it to list the nodes in my Kubernetes cluster. Except there's one catch here. At the time of recording, there is a bug in Calico CTL where you'll get this version mismatch error. I checked on the GitHub issues page, and it's actually only a couple of days old, so it's not going to be resolved for this recording, but depending on when you're watching this video, you may or may not encounter this. That being said, I'm going to add this allow version mismatch flag because it's not going to affect the demo if we use that. But now Calico is allowing me to list the nodes in my cluster, and I'll go ahead and verify that by going into the cluster here in my GKE console, going to nodes, and then scrolling down, and you can see those do match the nodes. So we know it's installed, it's connected to my Kubernetes data store, and we're ready to do some work with Calico. So we actually don't need the console for the rest of this demo. I'm going to go ahead and just open it up in a new window here. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to create a new Kubernetes deployment that we can use to test the networking policy that we'll create with Calico. So first I'm going to create a new namespace called Calico Policy NS, or Calico Policy Namespace. Next, I'll create a deployment to that namespace, and I'll just deploy a simple Nginx server. And then I'll go ahead and expose that Nginx server on port 80. Now that that's done, I want to create a new pod with BusyBox so that I can run some tools alongside Nginx that I'll use to manage it or to show the demo here. So there's my prompt. I'm in a BusyBox pod that is alongside my Nginx pod. And I'm going to go ahead and just run a wget on Nginx here, and you see I am getting the Nginx welcome page back. So I know my ingress rules to the pod are working. Let's see if I can go out to the public internet and do the same with google.com. So, yep, there we go. That's I'm going to recall this last command just so you can see it. But I just ran the same command again against Google, and of course it returns a lot more than a simple Nginx server. So let's clear the screen. Now that we know that's working, I'm going to open up a new tab here. I'll clear the screen one more time. So let's take a look at what I've got here. I've got the Calico CTL binary, which we installed earlier, and I've got this policy.yaml file. And that is a Calico networking policy document. So what this policy is doing is it's selecting this access pod, which is the BusyBox pod that we're running all these commands in, and it's going to allow egress from that pod. And you'll remember, this is the command that I went and created the BusyBox pod with, and it's got the access tag right there. I'm going to take that policy document and pipe it into the calico-ctl create command. And I've got the dash F parameter, but instead of specifying the file name, I'm going and reading it from standard input. I could just as easily substitute that dash for the name of the file or the path to the policy document. And then I've got the allow version mismatch flag. So let's run that. Now that that's applied, let's go back to our BusyBox pod and try and run those same commands again. So now my network policy has been applied and I'm back here in my BusyBox machine. Let's go ahead and try and reach outbound to google.com. And you see that still works fine. But now I'm going to try and do the same to the Nginx pod. And that is going to time out because we do not have a policy that allows that traffic anymore. So in this video, you learned how to set up a Kubernetes cluster with the network policy add-on, install and configure the Calico CTL plugin, and then apply a network policy to restrict traffic. Thank you for watching.